Hey, Mariner fans, welcome back to another episode of Monday Mojo, episode 80. It's Chris Sobba, your co-host with Chris Zweifel and Evan Barron, and we have a fun episode for you today. It's travel episode. We're all doing the field reporting. I'm coming at you live, ladies and gentlemen, from Salt Lake City, Utah, driving across country. As we all know, going from Seattle, moving to Charleston. It's a beautiful drive so far. Zweifel, he's taken in Unipa, as always, and Max Schwabe, he's out. He's out today. He's moving. Some excuses, I don't know. But he ain't here today. And, of course, as always, we got Evan Barron. Lots to talk about today. M's have been – there's good things, there's bad things. You know, a few guys are riding Miss Frizzle's struggle bus. You know, Kolten Wong, Tom Murphy, maybe even Julio Rodriguez is kind of on that. Kelenic, though, on the other hand, dude's doing what he's been doing all season, and he's continuing to do it. And so we love what we've seen from him. Two games in a row with opposite field homers. You love to see that. You love to see it. Bullpen struggles, a little bit concerned where we're at with there. We'll talk about that. And then also a little bit of struggles with the close games. I believe we're 3-5 in close games this year. And so it's typically, it's not what we've typically seen in the last couple of years with the Seattle Mariners and winning those close games. And as Dave Sims loves to say, the cardiac kids. Anyways, that's what we got. Zweifel, I got a great chance before we dive into baseball to see you. On my way on this cross-country road trip, I stopped in the Tri-Cities. I stopped at Zweifel's work. And Evan, let me tell you, man, this guy's restaurant, it was 5 stars. I felt famous. Two of the coworkers, like, oh, it's Monday Mojo's here. And I'm like, hey, how are you? And then some guy comes up, second service of bread. There's a table by me and Jake Siefkin. There's a table that came in, like, I don't know, 10 minutes after us, we got served one thing of bread. And about 10 minutes later, we get served another thing of bread. But by the way, this bread was phenomenal. The butter in it, phenomenal. And this table, I'm like, they haven't even gotten anything yet. But we're over here cashing in. But Zweifel, it was great to see you there. I got to give you a 5-star Yelp review.
What's the name of the restaurant, Zweifel?
Bud's Broiler. Yeah, down there on the water on the Columbia River. It's a good spot. I hooked Chris up with some appetizers. My favorite is the shaking beef appetizer. So I gave him that. And then, you know, I saw that there was another appetizer up there. And I go, you know what? This one's easy to make. I'm going to take this one, too. So I gave him it's the cowboy caviar. So it's like chips.
Wasn't that going to somebody else? You're like, hey, take that to him.
Yeah.
I was loving it.
It was going to another table. And I go, hey, can we just get another one of those? I'm taking this one. So I brought it over to Christopher and Jake. And it was good to see you. Yeah, it was good to see. It was good to have you see me. You know, it's good to be seen.
It is. It's good to see you in your natural environment and work managing. Zweifel is a manager. He's a big boss of Bud's Restaurant. It's a chain of Anthony's, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. So it's like we're under the Anthony's umbrella, but there's only one Bud's Broiler. So yeah, somewhat of a chain.
Well, I'll say this on my road trip so far. A few words of wisdom for anybody else taking road trips when they're towing a U-Haul trailer. After I got out of the Tri-Cities this morning, Zweifel, I was about, I don't know, an hour out, and there was a very beautiful scenic viewpoint or whatever you could pull over. I pulled over, let my dog out. You know, I chilled for a second, and then I just made sure everything was still secure, and I went to the back of the U-Haul, and fortunately, I have so much shit in there. It's packed to the brim. There's almost 0 inches of space. And the back trailer lift, you know, the door that goes up, that wasn't latched for about an hour driving on the freeway. That wasn't latched. And so I got back there and I was like, oh my God. Yeah, that was. And so I'm like, oh my goodness. Like, thank God I didn't hit crazy bumps, or thank God I had so much stuff packed in there because it didn't allow the door to go up and down. But if I didn't notice that, I drove almost 12 hours today, something like that. Dude, that would have been a mess. And so also, that was all there. But let's dive into Miss Frizzle's struggle bus. I want to start with there. Kolten Wong, if you're not going to be performing at the plate, you've got to be performing in the infield. And today, when J.P. Crawford, I'm listening to it on the radio, and correct me if I'm mistaken, but there was a liner hit to J.P. Crawford. He leaps up, catches it, and then he tries to fire one to Kolten Wong to double up and get out of the inning. Hits Kolten Wong's glove, hits the ground. He should have gotten it, right?
Oh, it was just a flip. He just flipped it to him.
He just flipped it. Okay.
And then he just dropped the ball.
Yeah. Well, was it next pitch? Next pitch is a 3-run homer.
Next pitch or the pitch after that. Yeah.
Next batter. Next batter was a three-run homer. They take the lead, and they ended up scoring one more throughout the game, and it ended up being 7-3, the final score. But it's going to be a much different game for Chris Flexen, for the Seattle Mariners, for everybody, if Kolten Wong catches the damn ball. And a guy who's batting 140 on the season, last seven games, batting 211, 140 on the season. If you're going to be making mistakes in the field as well, you got no room on a major league baseball team. There's no room for you. And so I'm loving what we're seeing from Jose Caballeros. And this week he got his first MLB hit. It was a double. Julio hit a homer, piss missile homer, screaming over the left center field wall and brought in Caballeros. That was on Wednesday, I believe. And I'm hoping Caballeros can maybe be that guy that can be second base for the Seattle Mariners, who we have not been able to find. But yeah, what are you thinking on Kolten Wong? You gotta do one or the other if you're gonna be on the team.
Last episode I went off on Kolten Wong, and it was kind of weird because today he went 3-for-4, but the biggest impact he had on that game was dropping that little ball, would have prevented three runs from coming across. And that was the ball game right after that happened. So and even though he went 3-for-4, they're just dinky little hits. I mean, he doesn't slug at all. If he does get a hit, 3-for-4 is nothing to bat an eye at, but it's like they're all singles. And then, I don't like his approach. I don't like his at bats. And then, to parlay what you were talking about, Caballero hit in his first game. He came in as a defensive replacement, but his first full game where he got some at bats, he hits three balls hard, doesn't get a hit. And then the next game gets a double. And I think he even had another hard hit ball. So, long-term, is he going to be the answer? I don't know, but right or struggling, you throw him a life vest and you sit him on the bench. And Kolten Wong needs to be sat on the bench right now until in batting practice, or, you give him a 3-day breather and he comes back and maybe goes 2-for-5 and you say, okay, you can play now. But right now, you can't have him in there. I mean, that's just, he's hurting the team.
He's not helping at all. He's completely hurting the team. Tom Murphy isn't doing much better. He's hurting the team. He's batting 0.77 on the season. He's not even at a dollar.
Yeah, it's the exact same thing for Murphy. I mean, and it doesn't seem like the guys like Murphy and Pollock are hitting lefties at all. Pollock doesn't have a hit against lefties, I don't think. He did have a nice double. I think it was Saturday or Friday's game. That was kind of nice to see. But Murphy hasn't hit lefties at all. It was supposed to be a platoon, or he was going to play DH against lefties. He's worthless right now. And, Pollock, who it's kind of nice to see him break out somewhat, but he doesn't have a hit against lefties, and that's what we brought him here to do. So, it's just the free agent acquisition.
That's not right. No, that ain't right. Pollock doesn't have a single hit against lefties. That came out
here. That was on Friday. Yeah, maybe if he squeezed one in.
That was a stat line going into the weekend.
Yeah.
But let me just hear me out. I think AJ Pollock hasn't really got the amount of reps that he would face against lefty, because Jared Kelenic's been having a great, outing in left field, where we thought, Kelenic was only going to hit right-handers and not face lefties, but you see Kelenic's able to handle both sides of the ball. So I think, box. But I would just say put AJ Pollock in as the, permanent DH for now, at least, and just have
Kelenic. We have nothing at DH. That'd be better. Yeah, I like that.
Exactly.
Idea.
So that's just what I'm seeing from that area.
And Kelenic, let's talk about Kelenic, because those, as I mentioned at the very beginning of this episode, the last two homers that he had, the first one was a fastball low and in to Jared Kelenic, and he pops it over the left field wall. He ropes it over the left field wall. And then the next day, today, I didn't see it because I was listening on the radio. Shout out I put out a post on Instagram, because as I was driving, I didn't have access to, it was Logan, _Logan. Yeah, I put out a post. I was like, hey, somebody help. Give me some ideas to stream this game. And the 710 app, I made it work, and he gave me that idea. Anyways, the first second I turn it on, Jared Kelenic's opposite field home run. And two games in a row for him to do that this guy, Dave Simms, said this wonderfully on the radio. He said, it's something else to physically watch somebody mature in front of your eyes, to see how recent, you know, last year and the year before, how shitty he was, how in his own head he was, which I still think he's in his own head. I'll talk about that in a second. But to where he's at now, leading the team in batting average, leading the team in home runs, I'd assume leading the team in slugging. I didn't look at that. But he's on fire. You mentioned his defense as well. The dude's doing everything and then some. But Max and I went to the game on Wednesday, last Wednesday. It was my last game in Seattle. And my goodness, we bought tickets in section 117, row like 10, for $4 on the Game Time app. I don't know how that worked after, like, what? After tax. Yeah, after tax, it was $10 a piece, 20 bucks. But on the Game Time, it said $4. And then we were able to move up to section 120. So closer, we were very close to the dugout. And there were seats in the first, second, and third row that were just wide open. So we go sat down in the third row. And I was keeping a very close eye on Kelenic because there were a few at-bats where he was back to, you know, what it seems who Kelenic was the last 2 years in terms of his anger, slamming his helmet on the ground. Fuck! And he'd wait like 5 seconds and like he's kind of just stomping around and still furious. Fuck! Like another 5 seconds, he just keeps screaming fuck like every 5, 6, 7 seconds. I'm like, oh my God. And then Teoscar would bring out his glove and they'd go to center field and start warming up. Maybe Jared Kelenic, because I was thinking, I was like, this guy needs to find his happy place. He needs to watch Happy Gilmore. He needs to find his happy place and go there immediately after something doesn't go right. And then he's still kicking ass. He has two games in a row with home runs. I'm like thinking to myself, maybe Jared is happy when he's angry. Mm-hmm. Maybe his anger is his happy place. And so maybe all of us fans telling him to change and not be angry is telling him to not be happy. I want the guy to be happy. I don't know what makes him happy, but I'm just kind of guessing here.
Yeah, he could be onto something. I know that Flexen, it seems like, who hasn't been pitching well, by the way. I know that Flexen seems to be one of those guys that when he's like fiery and kind of, you know, almost pissy on the mound, like he'll get out of an inning. You'll see there'll be like a guy on first and second. Let's say he gets out of the inning, didn't allow any runs, and he's walking off. He's just like shaking his head like, oh my God. Like, and you know, I think he was just trying to get himself fired up, but there's people like that. About Kelenic, Service said that last year, there's no chance he hits that pitch that was inside the first home run. He goes, last year, there's no way he hits that pitch out. And especially Oppo, like, you know, if you're going Oppo with your power, it means you're letting balls get deep into the zone, which means you can see him, and then you are sending them into orbit like he's doing. You know, pole side home runs are fun because it just looks pretty. But when you're letting a ball travel deep into the zone, especially it's inside on your hands, to hit that ball out to left field with that much power is really, really impressive. And then he does it again today. So I think the Kelenic thing is real. You know, is he going to be on this type of a heater for the rest of the year? No. And he's going to go through some struggles again. It'll be interesting to see when he goes through another struggle, because he will, how he gets himself back on track and then where he goes from there. Because when you're on a heater and everything's going right, you know, stuff seems to happen for you. And it's just like the opposite. When you're struggling, you'll rip a ball into the gap and a guy will make a great play. And it's just like, that seems to be the way baseball works. So it'll be interesting. I'm not hoping he does, but just because it's baseball, he's going to fall off again. And once he does fall off again, it'll be interesting to see how he responds to that. But I think the Kelenic show is here to stay. I think it's real.
Speaking of shows and good players, the J-Rod show. He's low-key on Miss Frizzle Struggle Bus, but he's batting over the last 7, 222. On the season, 245. 4 homers, 12 ribbies, 5 stolen bases, leading the team in 5 in stolen bases. 245 for Julio Rodriguez is 245 is a very it's just below average for MLB, right? If we're just speaking batting average. And for Julio Rodriguez to be there and for him to be on our struggle bus, I think that just speaks to how good he is, right? And how much talent he has. And also one thing before I forget this, Rick Riz on the radio today asked Dave Sims the question. He's like, is it okay? Are we good to be calling Julio? We don't call him like, you know, Rodriguez. And I'm like, wait, what do you mean? Of course it's Julio. Julio's already a household name. And Dave had to kind of low-key convince Rick Riz that. And I was like, come on, Rick. Come on. We already know Julio's a household name. So anyways, Julio, when he gets it on, when he gets out of this little slump, and if Kelenic can just stay remotely to where he's at, holy shit. I mean, Teo, he's bouncing forward right now, too. Teo's on fire. His defense is on fire. But and Julio's defense is still on fire as well. But damn, dude, if we can get Julio up to 275, he gets out of this little funk. He's swinging early, and he's falling behind in counts real early and having to chip away. You know, a few times, it's, you know, 1, 2, 3 strikes, he's gone. And he's not working the count, and he's seeming too hungry up there. But then, damn it, when he hits that ball, it's hit hard. But today, I heard he grounded out in a double play after hitting the ball hard. But I don't know, man. I'm going to put him on the struggle bus. But he can get – if he can just get something turned around just a little bit, that'll make a load of difference. The Mariners right now are the 25th batting team in the entire league. That's pretty ass. That's pretty ass. And so we got a few guys that just need to – go up a couple of notches. Ty France has been on fire. Teo, keep climbing up. JP Crawford hasn't been hitting great the entire season. He's been hitting better as of late, but he's also been getting on base a ton. I believe he's got Dave Sims said something like 16 games in a row of being on base. Eueno Suarez, same thing. He's got like 17 on base game streak.
Eighteen of nineteen.
Kelenic, I think today he reached 17 games. That's a record for him. That's a personal record. He PR'd there. And so we're not far. It looks like we're far off. And again, it's early in the season, a month in. I don't know. I mean, we got a few little pieces, the DH spot in pitching. Robbie Ray, get him back. I want to see what he can do. But I don't think we're as far off as some people think we might be.
I got a question for you guys. So maybe this might affect Julio's stats going forward, but do you guys like the lineup where it's at right now? Do you like Julio leading off? Would you like to see him maybe bat more down the order and have a chance to drive in some more runs, or would you like to see Kelenic maybe moved up in the lineup, or you like him being at six, or what do you guys think about the lineup right now?
I'm fine where it is right now. I don't want to mess with Julio. I think that, you know, we found a formula last year that works, him batting first. And Kelenic, obviously, you don't want a hitter that is that good batting sixth, but it's almost like you don't want to mess with him right now either. I mean, you move him up.
I was just going to say, I want him to stay there. I like where the lineup is. I just want somebody who's in the seven hole to freaking be able to do something when Kelenic ropes a double. Every time he gets on base, he rarely ever gets scored in unless he's hitting himself in via home run.
Is it too early to bring up a guy like a Cade Marlowe or let Cooper Hummel play more? Or
didn't Cooper Hummel just get sent down?
Yeah,
did he get sent down?
I believe so.
Yeah, because Sam Haggerty got activated from the IL.
Hmm. Yeah, and Caballero is going to stay up. It's time to look at some of these guys like at the bottom of the order. And I don't know if you can swing a trade this early. It's usually pretty hard to do that because, you know, certain teams don't even know if they're sellers yet, but I, you could call up like the, you know, Oakland Athletics and see if, you know, you can get a guy like a Seth Brown or one of their better hitters. They're always in sell mode. So actually I think Seth Brown just went to the IL. So maybe scratch that, but I don't think it was smart to go into this year with the DH spot like we had it. I think that our bullpen is definitely going to be better, but right now when our pitching is not carrying us, it seems that our offense, it stands out to be a sore thumb. You know, when everything's going right and we're playing Mariner baseball and we're only allowing 2 runs, you know, you don't notice it as much, but when, you know, the bottom of the order is going 0-for-12 or Julio has an off night, like we can't even afford for Julio to have an off night. Cause no one else picks up the damn slack. So We could also talk about the bullpen. I know you wanted to go there.
Well, well, you mentioned Cade Marlowe, and I would like to see him. He did suffer an oblique strain that sidelined him in early March, but since then, since his return in 24 plate appearances, batting a slash line of 316, 458, 632 with an OPS of 1.090. He's got four ribbies, four doubles, and triple. That's in 24 plate appearances in his first five games for Triple A Tacoma. Coming back from injury, picking up right where he left off. I mean, that's give him a bit more time, right, to come back from the injury fully, you know, play. But I don't think you're far off from saying, you know, give a guy like Cade Marlowe a chance. I think he's somebody to be, you know, he's objects are closer than they appear in the side mirror. I saw that a ton when I was driving today, looking in my mirror. Objects are closer than they appear. Cade Marlowe, I think he's closer than he appears.
Fair enough. Is Tommy La Stella still on the team, or do we need to did we option him yet? I haven't seen him in a long time. But if we did,
what's the kind way to forget you? Forget Tommy La Stella. Forget it. That guy, dude. We pinched hit him at the game I was at with bases loaded. Granted, we didn't have anybody else to put there because this is on Wednesday. It was after Cattaralli had been pinched hit with the bases loaded. Cattaralli struck out, and then Tommy La Stella came in to pinch hit. And it was like, what are we doing? I know we have no other options to pinch hit here, but the fact that Tommy La Stella is an option, come on, what the fuck are we doing? Of course, guess what he did? He popped it, you know, about a mile in the air and about 20 feet forward.
Yeah, I'm done with the Tommy La Stella experience. It's like when we were fooling around with, you know, Steven Souza last year and the Mike Ford experiment. Like, can we just get a guy
Mike Ford's still on our team? That experiment's still collecting up.
I know, but he's
not. Mike Ford. Dish. Okay, so Mike Ford hit a bomb in Tacoma that, like, yeah, it like left the it like pretty much left this. It left the entire stadium. Like, it was that. Like look it up. I'm telling you, look it up on YouTube.
I hope Jerry didn't see that.
All right, Evan, plug it in the YouTube.
Plug it in, but he hit a bomb. I remember watching it in the King 5 Sports highlights, so shout out King 5 Sports for that. So.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
Yeah. I hope we're done
grand
with that.
Grand Slam, too, yeah.
It was a Grand Slam, too?
Yeah, it was a Grand Slam, yeah.
Oh, jeez.
Teron's pitch is swung on and hit high and deep to right. Back this goes, and it is gone. Mike Ford with his second home run of the game. And it's a grand slam.
Yeah, man, I don't understand what we thought we were doing. You know, getting these old guys to, you know, like a Tommy La Stella who has no power. He never had any power. The slap hitting guy that the best part of his career is over. Like, it never fired me up. And, you know, it's kind of a bullshit, you know, saving money type deal where there was guys out there like, you know, Conforto or, you know, I think Hunter Renfroe was out there. Like, there were some good guys out there that would have fit in perfectly for the seventh hole. Anyways, what about the bullpen, Chris? What do you think?
So I don't love what I've been seeing. I'll put it there.
Diego and Penn Murphy have not been great.
Penn Murphy, we're having to use him too much. And I think we're using them in more situations where we typically wouldn't use them. What's the phrase that we would always use for Seattle Mariners bullpen? Like
the swing man.
Nope, that wasn't it. It's
yeah,
like,
it was.
No, not swing man. It's like using them to their in their perfect situation.
Oh,
situational. I don't know. Anyways, I think we're overusing Penn Murphy and. Paul Sewald, I think, is still leaving stuff over the plate. The other night when he got the save, we got lucky that we had a couple more insurance runs because he gave up a home run to the smallest guy on the Cardinals.
Yeah, you saw that home run. It wasn't crushed or anything. The guy pulled it down the line.
I see that it was crushed because he was such a small guy. He got all of it.
It had like an exit velo of like 90.
Yeah.
But, you know, no, but I have no problem with Paul Sewald. That's always the Paul Sewald experiences. You know, the ball's going over the middle, but it's just barely missing the barrel of bats, and he's striking them out. I like what Seawald's done. The guys that have scared me so far are Luis Castillo, number one.
He's always scared us.
And then Penn Murphy doesn't look like he's the same guy. Trevor Gott's been great. Yeah, it's just we definitely need Munoz to come back. And whatever happened to Casey Sadler? Is he going to come back at any time this year? I loved him. You remember Casey Sadler?
Yeah, no, I do remember Casey Sadler very well. And I don't think he's – hold on. Is he on the Seattle Mariners still?
He missed all of last year with Tommy John, but
maybe he's still, yeah, no, he's still recovering from his injury.
We need him back.
Yeah, he'll be good to be back, to have back. We'll have to find, he's keeping it slow while rehabbing. That was a month ago. Mm-hmm. But we'll see what happens with him. We'll see what happens with him. Who's this guy that you mentioned earlier that we just brought up in the bullpen?
Lefty Taylor Sassuedo.
Sassuedo? Has he pitched yet?
Yeah, he pitched today.
Did he give up one run?
Yeah, I think he did give up a run, but he looked pretty good. I kind of liked what I saw. He's a different looking guy than we have. A lefty, and he's a big guy. He's like 6'5", and kind of throws from a 3/4 slot. It's kind of a sweeping motion. It looked kind of interesting. I mean, you know. Whenever Jerry brings up a bullpen guy, I'm like, well, they see something in this guy because, he's on the Seattle Mariners.
Is he a lefty version of Steven Cishek with the arm angle?
No. Cishek's more bent over. He's more side slot. Like,
I'm telling you, he got bent over when he was pitching for us by the other teams.
Hey, we don't talk like that, okay?
No, we don't, no.
Actually, Sassuedo did not give up a run, and he struck out a guy.
Okay, cool. I know somebody in the bullpen gave up the 7th run. I just don't know who, because I lost connection.
But, oh, another guy, Gabe Spire, that we have, another lefty, 7.2 innings pitched, 0 earned runs. So
still 0 earned runs. We mentioned him on the last episode. Good, okay. Pretty interesting. Hey, let's transition from bullpen to starting pitching, one starting pitcher.
Wait, hold on. Penn Murphy, 2.16 ERA. So are we just high or what?
I think we're high, and I am, definitely.
I'm not.
Yeah. I'm sorry for all the things that I said to you. Apologies of a thug. That's from me to you, Marco Gonzalez. 9 Ks in the outing. I got to see him. In the last game I got to see, he pitched on Wednesday. 9 Ks. We didn't get the W, but damn. His first game back from paternity leave, and it only lasted like he missed one start, and he went 6 strong, maybe a little bit more, but 9 strikeouts. He was looking really good. He almost got Jesse Winker to strike out 3 times. Jesse ended up getting a hit off of him with 2 strikes in the count, but he looked really good.
Yes, he did. And the whole time I could barely focus on the game. I just kept thinking about you and Max and how you guys should apologize to him. No, I listened to that game on the radio, but it sounded like he was dicing him up. 9 Ks is not like at all what he does. So interesting to see maybe if he's found a pitch, what it looked like he was doing. Like just getting out ahead and then filling him with his cutter or changeup.
Yeah, I couldn't tell you, man. I can see that stuff much better on the TV. You know how it is when you're at the game, you can't see what the ball's doing. I was going to ask you. I was hoping you would have that answer.
Fair enough. It's like when we were watching from the bleachers, but we could see that time we could see it. We could see what Seawald was throwing, and we were just
slider, chop, slider.
Yeah, slider. Yeah. Well, no, yeah, it's good. We need Marco to be good, especially until with Flexen not pitching his best and Ray still a little bit out. And, you know, I love Kirby and Gilbert, but they're not quite where I thought they would be. Luis Castillo has been awesome. And I'm not even complaining about Gilbert and Kirby, but they're not dominant right now.
No.
So with, you know, Flexen not being great, I mean, if Marco can just have a really good month, because he's done it before. He's had these really good months, and then we kind of forget that, and he has a bad month, and we hate him again. But we'll see if he can build off of it. You're chewing. What are you chewing?
I was eating a Reese's. I stopped at the gas station and got a ton of those Reese's Minis. What's coming up, man? What's coming up? We got an off day tomorrow.
Yeah, the Phillies are coming up.
No. We're going. We're going to Philly. We're going to go.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Cheesesteaks. We're going to go eat some cheesesteaks, get some heart problems, because that's what they do to you. I'm excited for this one. I don't know when the last time we went to Philadelphia was. City of brotherly love, my ass. I trained through Philadelphia once from Boston when I was going to Baltimore. And, man, it is a POS, at least the outskirts of what I saw from the train. It looked just so shitty. And this is a stadium. I think it would be really bad if I were following the Seattle Mariners. I'd have a tough time. I'd have a tough time visiting the Mariners there because of how brutal they are to any fan.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking Philadelphia sports fans in general. I would love to go see Patty's Pub. Shout out. It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. But I'm excited for this series. You know, this is going to be a chance for do we got anybody that – no, J.P. Crawford Redemption Series. That's what it is. J.P. Crawford Redemption Series.
Yeah, and then they got Taiwan Walker pitching against us the second game. So.
Oh, that's going to be fun.
Yeah. First game, we're pitching, I think, their fifth starter, Bailey Falter. And he has a 4.5 ERA. So it'd be nice to get the first game. And then we got Logan going. So then we got Marco that second game. And then it should be Kirby.
And then Toronto fans, they got some beef with us. We got Toronto right after Philadelphia on Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Last time we were there, Cal Raleigh hit a home run, and we moved to the next round of the playoffs. Mm-hmm. Pretty sweet. Cal Raleigh hit the go-ahead in that, right? I'm not tripping.
No, Adam. Well, that's when we came back.
I'm tripping. I'm tripping the clinch.
Yeah, you're tripping, Matt. Adam Frazier hit the double down the line for us to come back and win in Toronto in game two. At least Cal Raleigh hit a home run in game one. That's what started it off. But
yeah, it was like first inning.
Same series.
So you got partial of it, but yeah. So
he was a big part of the
Yeah, and then Teoscar returns as well. So that'll be cool to see too.
That'll be a lot of fun.
And we get to play against Swanson.
Oh yeah, he'll come. He might come in relief pitch against us.
Oh, he for sure will. He's on the our Monday Mojo fantasy baseball team.
Which you said we're 3-0.
We are 3-0. I did a bang up job on that draft, Chris. I got Kyle Tucker, Julio Rodriguez, Bo Bichette. So we'll see him.
No, we will. So Zweifel, I want to wrap it up with pick to hit, and then wrap it up again with a new version of pick to hit. I think you won. You said you won pick to hit. I had Jared Kelenic, and I mean, he went off.
Oh yeah, I thought we said you couldn't pick Kelenic.
No, I picked Kelenic, and then I said we can't pick Julio.
Wow.
I think if memory serves me right, but we'll you had Teo, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, Teo had quite a hell of a week. And so there's that.
Yeah, and Kelnick's kind of a cheap pick anyways.
Thank you. I need a W.
It's cheap.
Cheap. I know what you said.
Anyways, what's your new version of pick to hit?
Let's help people bust off the struggle bus. You know, we'll slump bust them off of it, but not really. Miss Frizzle will. And they'll get off Miss Frizzle's struggle bus. Mm. I want to pick... So I want us to pick somebody who's last seven games, you know, batting below 250, something along those lines, but somebody who's not doing good and who we'll all pick somebody who's on that struggle bus to have the best week out of those people. I don't know if you like that. I'm just spitballing here, freestyling.
Sure. Why not?
Yeah. I don't know. You didn't sound like you liked it that much.
Oh, we can do whatever you want.
Yeah. When I was thinking about this idea, talking to myself in the car, not saying it out loud, it like sounded really good. and now I'm talking about it, and it's not as solidified as I wanted it to be. And I don't feel it. Let's try it out. It's as powerful as I thought it was going to be.
It's not as powerful. It's just so powerful. You know what that's from? I got this sign in my head, and when I close my eyes, it's just so powerful that the sign explodes.
That sounds like South Park.
No. From Boogie Nights, Mark Wahlberg.
I have not seen that. I haven't seen
Boogie Anyways, Nights. Let's play your game.
Okay, let's play my game. I wanted to
actually, Evan, you got to put that into the episode. Boogie Nights, it's like the sign. It's just so powerful.
Excuse me, Jack?
Yeah.
I was thinking about what the Colonel was saying, you know, about my name.
Uh-huh.
I was just wondering if you had any ideas.
I had some thoughts on it, yeah. What about you? What do you think?
Well, my idea was, you know, I just want a name. I want it so it can cut glass, you know, like razor sharp.
Razor sharp, right.
Yeah, well, when I close my eyes, I see this thing. It's like this big sign. And the name is in, like, bright blue neon lights with, like, purple outline. And this name is just so bright and so sharp that the sign, it just blows up because the name is just so powerful. It says Dirk Diggler.
I think heaven has sent you here, Dirk Diggler. I think the angels have blessed us all because of you.
Dirk Diggler.
I'm picking JP Crawford. He's going back to Philadelphia, and I don't want to. Oh, God dang it. Nah, I'll pick JP Crawford. I think JP Crawford is going to hit his first home run of the season this week against Philadelphia.
Okay. Not that he's been struggling, but he does have a 3.5 ERA. I think it's 3.57. Logan Gilbert, I think he comes out there and he has one of his best starts of the career of the season against one of the best lineups in the majors. So look for Logan Gilbert to get back to Gilbert things.
How many innings do you think he's gonna go?
I'll give him 7 innings, 10 Ks.
You're gonna give him 7 and 10. Okay. And I like that you picked a pitcher.
Yeah, why not?
I'm gonna go with AJ Pollock. My theory is because he played with the Dodgers and the Diamondbacks, and he has familiarity with playing against the National League and all that back in his day. And so I think that could come into fruition. And I like that he got that big hit or that big double on Friday night against the Cardinals, and just give him more reps, man. I think he can provide that a clutch hit here and there and whatnot, but I'm gonna go with that this week.
Mr. Pollock, nice.
Well, that's a wrap, ladies and gentlemen. Monday Mojo, I gotta get to bed. It's 12:30 a.m. in Salt Lake City, Utah. I got another, I don't even know where I'm ending up tomorrow. I have no plan. If I was traveling with me and I wasn't myself, but I was some other random person traveling with me, I would fucking hate me. I would hate Chris Sobba if I was traveling with him, because I plan nothing, no itinerary, no route, no stops planned. It's just that I go with the flow. And so I have no idea where I'm going to end up tomorrow, but I know it's going to be like 12 hours of driving. I got to get my ass to bed. But when you're listening to this, drink your coffee. It's Monday morning, baby. Monday Mojo. We got a break today, but then Philly, Toronto, we're coming at you. That's it. Go M's. Mona Lisa, could I get a date on Friday? And if you're busy, I wouldn't buy tickets Saturday. Hey. Wrong dog, they bossy Fuji coming around the way. I don't puff blood, so I always got my breath. Never had to battle with a bulletproof vest. They call me Cockweasel, but I still kick my chest. I don't wear Jerry Girls, cause I'm not from the West. No disrespect to the West, true indeed. I rock it to the East is the sea. The seed of them days back, your sheep's getting hot tracks. Peace to Mr. Magic, things are getting tragic. Now we on some new stuff. Fit the Ku Klux, my own clan is acting up, I blame it on the Philly blood. What's your crew to do? Kids are acting, ooh, and it's getting better. Yo, where's the corporate data? Mr. Three-Piece Suit, check the square root, your bones and Timberland boots. Nah, that's the surface. And all the bombing deeps, I got a heck full of problems in the hand, full of nappy roots. I've been a Jones coming down, yo, I got the slang to make the